Hello friends, this problem is on field efficiencies. So the problem says like this: plot co-ops of field efficiency versus row length from 0.2 to 1.5 km. When planting corn with a 4 planter at 8 km per hour, the speed is 8 km per hour. Row to row spacing is given 100 cm of the planter, and the average turning time at each end is 15 seconds for either down the row speed. So generally, we assume that the operator throttle down from 8 km per hour to turn. So generally less than 8 km per hour is used, but the 15 second is given. So there is no need of this throttle down or whatever. The time required for filling speed of seed hoppers and other miscellaneous interruption is 4.5 minute per hectare. So generally 4.5 minute is required to sow the seed for 1 hectare. So 4.5 minute. Plus 7% of the effective operating time is lost in other miscellaneous operations. Okay, so let's then start how to proceed. So let's do then. So first, starting from the row length. The row length we take 0.2. So let's take the 0.2 kilometer is the length, or you can say it's 200 meter. So 4 row planter and 100 meter spacing. So therefore the total width of the planter will be 4 into 100 or that will be 400 centimeter, or you can say 4 meter. 4 meter is the width of the planter, seed planter. So now, as we know, theoretical field capacity is CT, you can say. There is theoretical speed into theoretical width of implement into 3600 divided 10,000 per hectare. Or you can directly use kilometer per hour speed into width in meter divided by 10 to find out the field capacity, that is in hectare per hour. So operating speed is given 8 km per hour. So you can convert it into meter per second to use in this formula, or you can use directly this kilometer per hour in this formula. So now we can use this 8 km per hour in this formula, so that the CT will be equal to 8 into 4. 4 is the width, already we know this width. So divided by 10, so that will be 3.2 hectare per hour. So this is theoretical field capacity. Now we have to find out the actual field capacity. To find out the actual field capacity, we have to find out the time taken to seed, that means plant 1 hectare. So let's find out area. First, area is taken as 10,000 meter square or 1 hectare. Since effective width is 4 meter, if there is no turning losses or any other losses, what will be the time to complete the operation? That is TE, or effective time, that is area is 10,000 meter square divided by 4 is the width, and 20/9 we calculated from here the speed. That is meter into meter per second. So you can find out the time in second to plant 1 hectare of land. So 1125 seconds. This is common irrespective of the length of the row. So if row of the length of the row changes also, so it will remain same. So TE is same for all different type of different length of row. Okay. So next, go to the turning time loss. So turning time loss is number of turns into time per each turn. So next, the most important thing to find out the time loss during turning. So it is not given. So the turning loss is dependent on the number of turns per hectare. So now we calculate, since we have taken 1 hectare is the area. So let us, this is 1 hectare. So 1 hectare of the area, this one. Okay, so then the length of the row related this one from this to this, so it's given 0.2 kilometer or 200 meter. Okay, so that is 200 meter. Okay, so now, so this side definitely due to this width, only number of turns will be depending on this width, because width into length will be the area. So then width each pass how much width it will cover? 4 meter. As we know, 4 meter is the width of the planter. So let it, this is 4. So this one is 4 meter. Okay. So then this is 200. So if 1 ton, it will area cover the area 200 into 4. If you see this one, this area is 200 into 4. So total area is 10,000 meter square, and this one is 200 into 4. So if you divide by the area 10,000 square meter divided by this area, then you can find out this plot 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. For this, let it in this case that there will be, let it number of we will not calculate here, but let it the due width first to move like this, then it will turn here. Okay, then again it will turn here, then it will go like this, it will turn here, next it will go like this, it will turn here, and it will go like this. This way it is finished. So now if you see, let 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 turns you can find out from the width and everything. Then if you see, if 6 is the plot, then it will turn 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So because it's 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, but only 5 turns is there. That means n minus 1. So if n is the number of plots, then it's n minus 1. So this one we have just calculated here. So this is the area divided by this each plot area. Is this one, you can see this is the one in the here. Okay, so if you see, then minus 1, because we number of plots, minus 1 is the number of turn. So 11.5 is the number of turn if you calculate. So once you calculate the number of turns, then you can just find out the lost time lost during the turn. So that T1 will be equal to 11.5 into 15. So that is 172.5 seconds. So time loss for filling seed hoppers, T2 will be equal to this much, 5.4 already given. Other miscellaneous nitrogen loss, T3, it's given 7% of this. So it's this similar calculation, 7% of this. So the total time taken will be T plus T1 plus T2 plus T3. That is a total time, it is lost. So once you find out the total time, so you can find out in hour, then the effective or actual field capacity can be find out. Actual area covered is 1 hectare divided time taken is 0.4723, that is 2.117 hectare per hour. Then field efficiency can be calculated from this formula, that is CA by CC, actual field capacity divided by theoretical field capacity, that is 66.67. So once you find out for one, taking the row length is 0.2. So next you have to iterate it. So that means you have to change the row length to 0.3, 0.4, 0.5 up to 1.5 kilometer. So what I have done, I have made one table. So now here actually what you have to do actually, so you have to in this one 0.2 to 1.5, then you have to find out everything. So you have to calculate. CT is the theoretical field capacity, T is the effective time, N is the number of turns, T1, T2, T3, these three on the basis of the number of turns, you can find out this. Now you see these are same, only changing is this one is only changing for turns changing, this changing, everything, and also due to this change, this is changing, others are remaining almost same. So then this T total time is changing, then CA is changing, okay, CT is same. So CA by CT, that is field efficiency. Then you have to draw the graph between the row length and field efficiency. Then you will see when the row length increases, the field efficiency increases like a parabolic. So that means then initially it increases more, then it stabilizes. So you can draw this graph. So it is asking, so our problem is solved. Thank you.